In terms of the issues in the visit, as I said, the centerpiece of his visit is the conclusion of the land boundary agreement. We see at one level this having an impact across the board on the relationship. So we do think that this visit would consolidate and deepen the relationship. But other than the rising confidence levels, I think the point I would make is that it would actually help very much with the management of the border. That for both countries, we expect improvement of the security situation on the border. There will be more trust and confidence. We think that it would be much more effective for us to deal with illegal activities across the border, activities like human trafficking, circulation of counterfeit notes, drug smuggling, movement of people, illegal movement of people. So in terms of the stability and security on the border, we really think that both countries would benefit. In particular, the resolution of the problem of enclaves. The enclaves have in the past been territory which has been out of bounds for law enforcement agencies, and often they've been misused to seek refuge there by elements who have been undermining law and order. So there will be the clarity and the discipline which would come from having clearly demarcated borders. The fact that we are able to secure the border so much better allows us to do much more across the border. And I think a key factor here is connectivity. We expect during this visit to see more initiatives on connectivity, initiatives that would cover, I mentioned the bus services, but the movement of goods across the land border, the coastal shipping, inland waterways. So in a variety of ways, every aspect of movement of goods and people would in some form actually be addressed. We would even actually, we hope to have an understanding by which even telecom and internet would be benefited by cooperative arrangements between the two countries. I would also like to say a few words about our development cooperation with Pakistan, with Bangladesh. Many of you are aware that we have a line of credit with Bangladesh. We have on the first line of credit about 15 projects. 7 of these projects have been done. 8 of them are under implementation. The rough volume of our commitments is about $860 million. And most of this was in the railway sector. Now, during the visit, we would be looking forward to expanding these projects, taking our development cooperation with Bangladesh to many more areas. So we expect to see projects in the field of rail, of course, in power, in roads, in ports, in health, in education. So you will get a much more broad-based cooperative landscape. That certainly would be one of our objectives.